Good morning. I am Alka Negi Tomer, and we are delving into the philosophy of Buddha and Buddhism through different accounts from Buddha's life. Today we see how Buddha underwent deep dilemma after he reached Sambodhi and how he came out of it. Despite being the enlightened one, despite being Tathagat, having gone where no one had gone before, the Sakya Muni too had to face quandary. Siddhartha Gautam went into deep contemplation on the sufferings of the world and how to remove them. He had to use all that he knew and all that he had mastered to find the answers. He used Dhyan to focus on the topic, Sankhya to think logically, and Tapascharya to be able to ignore all the inconveniences and negativity that could arise out of such deep trance. He found the answers to his questions. It was desires that caused sufferings. Too many desires brought unhappiness, while too less of them brought sufferings. He realized that controlling the mind was the way out of sufferings. Now that his questions had been answered, he came out of his dhyan. He freshened himself, had little food, and then gave thought over what he had to do hereafter. He knew that his thoughts were revolutionary. It would be difficult for him to make people understand and follow his ideas. At that time, Brahminism, also referred to as Chatur Varna, was at its peak. Caste system, home and Agnihotra were given a lot of importance. Apart from the Brahmanic philosophy, there were 65 other philosophies fermenting in the society when Buddha got Sambodhi. Out of these, 6 are of special mention. First, Akriyavad by Purana Kashyap. It spoke of soul not being affected by any action that the body did, which meant that a person may do anything good or bad, it wouldn't make a difference as the soul was never affected with the work that the body did. The second was Niyati Vad by Makhali Khusal. It said that everything was predetermined, that all actions were pre-programmed to happen, thus they would not affect our future, which meant that man could not think or take charge of his own actions. The third, Uchedavad by Ajit Kesakambal, proposed that the soul cannot be removed from the sorrows of the world. It travels through 84 lakh cycles of Mahakalp, and then the unhappiness of the soul will end. The fourth, Anunyavad by Pakuda Kachayana, preached that the being constitutes of 7 elements: Prithvi, Apa, Tej, Vayu, Sukh, Dukh, and Atma. And these elements were indestructible. Even if a knife was put through a body, it only meant that the knife had entered the 7 elements. The being lived on. The fifth, Vikshupavada by Sanjay Belaputta, said that if someone asked him if there was heaven, he would say yes, if he felt so. Or he would say no, if he felt so. It all depends on what we feel and what we believe in. The sixth, Chaturyam Samvaravad by Nigantha Nathput, also known as Mahavir, he pronounced the suffering in the world is due to bad karma done in the previous lives. The sufferings can be gotten over by reducing the bad karma, and this could be done by following the fourfold path that followed the following 4 rules: not to kill, not to steal, not to lie, not to own property and to maintain celibacy. Buddha realized that what he understood of life and living would challenge most of these philosophies. He would have to take up the cudgel against all in one way or the other. He would have to face a lot of opposition from the masses. Being enlightened was an easy path as compared to what lay ahead, spreading the wisdom of his achievement. This was a great dilemma for a man who had seen the light of truth. He had two options: to die a wise man or to face the world and inform it about the great truth at the risk of being considered a madman. The first path was easy, the second was a challenge. Then he thought of the reason of his birth. His wife had implored him to look for answers to these questions for the sake of the world. He himself had undergone a lot of hardship, certainly not to keep the knowledge to himself. He had to spread the word. He had to tell the world. He had to share all that he knew. His Sambodhi was not for his own self. It was for the entire world. He had now understood that he was the Sakyamuni, the Tathagata, the Buddha. Coming up next is Buddha's first sermon. Kindly share your thoughts about it in our comment section. And don't forget to like, subscribe and share our channel. And please press the bell icons for notifications. Wait for the next video. Till then, stay healthy, stay safe. Thank you.